This video will serve as an open letter to the FAA, addressed to Stacy Z, Environmental Protection Specialist, and James Repchek, Manager Safety Authorization Division, in response to their September 17, 2021 posting on Twitter and the FAA website, asking for public input regarding the draft programmatic environmental assessment of SpaceX Starship Super Heavy Launch Vehicle Program. We are writing on behalf of our 31,000-member-strong online community. Our channel, the Common Sense Skeptic, has been following the activities of Elon Musk and SpaceX for several years now in producing video content based largely on Musk's various claims made starting in July of 2020. A written transcript of this will also be submitted to the FAA through your email link as requested. We had intended to go through this 150-plus page document point by point with our concerns, but we note that this document was not created by the FAA. This document was prepared by three environmental engineers who are SpaceX employees, and one employee named Brian Pownell, who is a transportation engineer working for a consulting firm named Kimley Horn & Associates. That firm seems to specialize in large city-scale infrastructure projects rather than anything remotely environmentally friendly. Upon completion, this document was submitted to RedCheck at the FAA for signing in and consideration. And, as part of that consideration, your agency is now asking for public input on this document, outlining SpaceX's continued sprawl across the general Boca Chica area. To set the tone of this letter, we, our channel, and our online community, are space enthusiasts, but we do not support Elon Musk's unsanctioned, reckless, and destructive activities in the Boca Chica area. And neither should the FAA, because the activities being conducted here do not resemble whatsoever the original intended, declared, permitted purposes of this site. A bit of history here. In the beginning, when SpaceX was shopping for launch sites and Texas threw their hat in the ring along with the city of Brownsville, Musk's declared intention was to establish a single launch pad and infrastructure for variations of the Falcon rocket, which was commissioned and endorsed by NASA to service the International Space Station as part of a $1.6 billion contract. This was how the proposed facility was to be built. To attract Musk and SpaceX to Brownsville, a list of incentives was presented to Musk, including $2.3 million from the Texas Enterprise Fund, and another $13 million through the Cameron County Spaceport Development Corporation, a private-public business which would quickly be turned against the residents of Boca Chica Village to force them out of their homes, on Musk's orders. As part of this incentive package, Texas also changed state laws to allow Musk to launch one rocket per month, on weekdays between 7 a.m. and 7 p.m., Monday to Friday, not on weekends and not on holidays. This state law also prevents SpaceX from being sued for noise complaints as a result of those launches, which were supposed to be Falcon 9 or Falcon Heavy launch vehicles. However, since accepting the state's invitation and money, Musk has been operating in the Boca Chica area as if he has absolutely no oversight. Instead of building a single launch facility similar to SpaceX leases in Cape Canaveral and Vandenberg Space Force Base, Musk has instead constructed a massive industrial complex and launch operations center in an area that is situated between no less than four separate ecologically important and sensitive areas. They are Boca Chica State Park, Brazos Island State Park, the Las Palomas Wildlife Management Area, and Boca Chica Beach. The launch area for SpaceX is directly adjacent to every single one of those protected areas. And Musk has built a completely separate industrial manufacturing complex that was never accounted for in any other assessment. In 2014, your office, the Federal Aviation Administration, released an EIS report commissioned in 2013 to evaluate the impact this launch complex would have on the surrounding environment and wildlife, with special emphasis on federally protected species. That assessment was conducted using the following parameters: that the site would be a single launch platform for a rocket system known as the Falcon that was launching NASA-endorsed missions in support of the International Space Station. And all of those facts are right there in your cover artwork. The Falcon rocket, which carries capsules called Dragons, either Cargo Dragon or Crew Dragon, is now a proven system. The Falcon being a 70-meter-tall multi-stage rocket requiring a propellant load of 395 tons in the first stage and another 92 tons in the second stage for a total of around 500 tons. According to the SpaceX User's Guide for Falcon, the noise rating inside the fairing of that vehicle is 131.4 decibels. With those parameters and logistics in mind, the FAA conducted their initial environmental assessment, and at the time, the FAA indicated concerns surrounding the federally protected and critically endangered mammal, bird, and reptile species of this area. Named in this report were the ocelot and jaguarundi, the aplomato falcon, piping plovers, and red knots, and the Kemp's ridley, hawksbill, leatherback, loggerhead, and green sea turtles, all of which are critically endangered. All of these species are named in the December 18, 2013 Final Biological and Conference Opinion, Consultation Number 02 Echo Tango Charlie Charlie 00 2012 Foxtrot 0186. Your final report, published in May of 2014, also noted the following state-protected species of flora and fauna in the area, including birds such as the white-faced ibis, Texas Boteri's sparrow, and the sooty tern. Also, this site is part of a migration corridor for over 500 species of birds making annual migrations. The Rio Grande Valley Birding Festival celebrates this site, and this single event brings in $463 million to the region each year. Additional mammals that were listed in your final report included the West Indian manatee, the southern yellow bat, and the white-nosed coati. The following reptiles were noted: the sheep frog, black striped snake, northern cat-eyed snake, speckled racer, Texas indigo snake, and the Texas scarlet snake. The Texas horned lizard, the Texas tortoise, the black spotted newt, the Mexican tree frog, the South Texas siren, and the white-lipped frog. There are also three types of plants on the state and federal endangered list that were noted: South Texas ambrosia, Texas cyania, and the star cactus. Both of these papers were drawn up using the parameters of the Falcon launch system, which would be landing their boosters either in the Atlantic Ocean or on barges for recovery, not on site. There are no relanding pads in any of these diagrams. But Musk is not launching Falcons into orbit from this site. He's destructively testing a much bigger, unproven launch vehicle that is much more powerful, more destructive, and far louder than the vehicle this site was originally considered for. And there is absolutely no chance the above-noted endangered creatures and plant life are not being adversely affected by the SpaceX expansionist and testing activities happening at Boca Chica. The 100-acre wildfire caused by Musk at this site in 2019 is proof positive that SpaceX cannot be trusted with this biologically and ecologically sensitive area. In fact, in that regard, Musk is quoted as telling the press, "We've got a lot of land with nobody around, so if it blows up, it's cool." It is important to recognize the difference between the Falcon 9 and the Starship, because these two vehicles bear no resemblance whatsoever to each other. The Falcon 9 with the Dragon capsule or fairing stands about 70 meters tall. The Starship, atop its Super Heavy booster, stands 120 meters tall. The Falcon 9 requires a combined propellant load of RP-1 refined kerosene and LOX totaling 500 tons, firing 9 proven Merlin engines at launch. The Starship Super Heavy combined vehicle requires 4,600 tons of liquid methane and LOX, firing up to 37 unproven Raptor engines at launch, as per SpaceX's submitted documents. The RP-1 propellant used by Falcon 9 is more stable at room temperature, stored at 20 degrees Celsius, and presents less of an explosion hazard than liquid methane, which has to be kept stored at minus 161 degrees Celsius as a cryogenic fuel. The Falcon 9 has a noise rating of 131.4 decibels inside the fairing, a result of the 1.7 million pounds of thrust it produces. In comparison, the Saturn V was measured at up to 220 decibels at the launch site, a result of the 7.6 million pounds of thrust it produces. And the Super Heavy booster is expected to produce twice the power of a Saturn V, with over 16 million pounds of thrust, potentially doubling the volume of a Saturn V vehicle launch. Decibels are measured on a logarithmic scale. For every 10 additional decibels, you are measuring double the energy being produced by a device. Let's call the volume of the Falcon 9 launch 130 decibels, round it down. At 140 decibels, it is double that volume. At 150 decibels, it has quadrupled. 160 decibels, factor of 8. 170 decibels, factor of 16. 180 decibels, factor of 32. 190, factor of 64. 200, factor of 128. 210 decibels, factor of 256. Making the Saturn V at 220 decibels 512 times louder than the Falcon 9. And since the Super Heavy program promises double that thrust, we should expect it to be up to twice as loud as the Saturn V, making it 1,024 times louder than a Falcon 9. But this level of energy is not experienced as noise. Above 194 decibels, sound is converted into a shockwave, and that shockwave will kill every living thing in the direct vicinity of the launch pad, and blast the eardrums out of every creature until that shockwave drops below 140 decibels. The destruction of hearing in an animal is often a fatal injury. The Falcon 9 at 131.4 decibels was always below the permanent hearing damage threshold. The Super Heavy at a possible 230 decibels would be 1,000 times greater. So the entire Appendix B of this document regarding the effects of noise referred to throughout this document is sheer unmitigated nonsense, since they use 150 decibels as the SPL in the immediate area of the launch site on their diagrams on page 11 of Appendix B. KBR has embarrassed themselves in this assessment by ignoring such obvious historical parallels using other known launch platforms, i.e. the Saturn V and Space Shuttle launches. Assuming their modeling is correct and their numbers were just low, we can swap out the 150 decibels they used with the known 220 decibels of a Saturn V launch and demonstrate that South Padre Island can expect to be blasted with 180 to 190 decibels of sonic energy, and every living thing in the Boca Chica area will be deafened or destroyed. These are demonstrable facts. So too is the destructive potential of the Starship and Super Heavy booster. In 2016, a Falcon 9 such as the one Musk said would be launching from Boca Chica exploded on pad SLC-40 at Cape Canaveral during propellant loading, meaning this vehicle was not yet filled with propellant. Yet this explosion was felt several miles away and destroyed SLC-40, taking almost a year to rebuild it. If this vehicle had been fully fueled, it would have contained only 10% of a combined Starship Super Heavy stack. The explosion was this catastrophic, and it was not fully fueled. By comparison, on a larger scale, in 1969, the Soviet Union launched a series of rockets known as N1s. N15L was the second such launch, and it crashed on the launch pad after clearing the tower. That explosion was measured in kilotons, estimates ranging from 1 to 7 kilotons. It decimated the launch complex and surrounding area, throwing debris 10 kilometers from the site and raining down burning fuel for half an hour. N1 was fueled up using RP-1 and LOX, with a total propellant load of around 2,300 tons. Starship atop Super Heavy carries twice this amount of methane and LOX for a total of 4,600 tons, meaning a loss of vehicle on the Boca Chica pad will be even larger with a greater degree of damage than the N1 catastrophe. At Cape Canaveral's Launch Pad 39A, where the Space Shuttle launched from, the closest civilian homes are 20 kilometers away in Titusville. At SpaceX's launch complex, the closest civilian homes are the remaining citizens of Boca Chica Village. They are only 2.5 kilometers away. The larger communities of Port Isabel and South Padre Island are only 8 kilometers away. Populated areas of Mexico are about 12 kilometers away. And the Rio Grande, which acts as the Mexican-US border in this area, is only 4 kilometers away. If operations at Boca Chica were being conducted with the same safeguards as the distance between Titusville and Pad 39A, this is what that safety radius would look like, extending well into Mexico. Just out of curiosity, has anybody bothered to ask Mexico what they think about ICBMs being launched only 2 miles from their territory? What agreements are in place with Mexico with regards to that launch site? And what happens if one of these rockets crashes in Mexico? And while we are on the topic of location, has it occurred to the FAA that if Musk's intention is to launch orbital rockets from this site, that this site is quite possibly the most ridiculous location imaginable? From Cape Canaveral in Florida, launches can take off in a wide swing of azimuths, but from Boca Chica, the corridor available for launches is extremely limited. When this process began, you gave Musk what he wanted based on what he promised, and then he took 10 times more. If the FAA continues down this path and just keeps rubber stamping what he's doing, he will never stop taking more than you agree to. In fact, despite the plans he outlines in this report bearing his company's name, these are not his end goals for this area by any stretch of the imagination. This PEA submitted by SpaceX only shows the next level of expansion he intends to pursue. But once he has these, he won't stop there. In April of 2021, the Dallas Morning News questioned whether or not Musk was creating his own city, and that went hand in hand with Musk sending out a general hiring call for people to move to Starbase USA, as he now calls the area. In June 2021, Texas Monthly declared Elon Musk is turning Boca Chica into a space travel hub. This is not what was proposed in the beginning. If it had been, it would have been shot down immediately. But Musk has snuck in under your noses and created this situation that you have not halted, and now you need to step up and shut it down before it gets any further out of hand. You, the FAA, began conducting this new environmental assessment a year ago, announced on November 23rd of 2020. You, the FAA, began taking public input on this topic at that time. Yet, since then, you have breached your own EIS and agreements with SpaceX by authorizing Starship launches known as HOPs for reasons unknown, with no safety assurances from SpaceX. On December 8th, 2020, the FAA authorized the HOP of SN8. That vehicle exploded on impact while landing. Despite SpaceX breaching their license with the FAA with the SN8 launch, and despite Musk attacking you on Twitter for holding up their progress, And despite Musk fueling up the SN9 craft in defiance of your do not fly order while you conducted an investigation, the FAA then went on to authorize the launch of SN9 on February 2, 2021. That craft also exploded on impact while landing. A month later, on March 3rd, you authorized SN10 to hop. That machine exploded 8 minutes after a hard landing. The same month, SN11 launched with your misguided approval through an impossibly foggy morning that should have grounded all craft. That machine never even made it back to Earth in one piece and contaminated many square kilometers of the protected sanctuary surrounding the Boca Chica area, spreading fields of stainless steel shrapnel across the landscape due to a mid-air explosion. Debris from that blast was flung 8 kilometers away. All of these incidents happened while your new EIS assessment was taking place, while you were taking public input on the destruction of the Boca Chica environment. And now, without FAA authorization and in defiance of warning letters from your office, Musk continues to build a 480-foot, 145-meter-tall launch tower on the very edge of their launch site, right next to the fence. Media reports that you, the FAA, have told Musk he is building the structure at his own risk, but Musk has, in sheer defiance of your warnings, continued to build. In fact, it is reported that Musk lied to your federal agency about this tower in May of 2021, declaring an environmental review was not necessary because this tower was not meant for launches and that they were only going to use it as an integration tower for production, research, and development purposes and not for FAA-licensed or permitted launches. Meanwhile, Musk and his company president, Gwynne Shotwell, were both telling SpaceX fans, employees, and investors in June of 2021 that Musk was planning to launch the first orbital Starship in July of 2021, the following month, landing in the Pacific Ocean off the coast of Hawaii. That launch would have required a tower. There is no other launch tower on the Boca Chica site. So Musk lied. Shotwell lied. And now SpaceX is installing arms on that same tower to catch the Super Heavy booster when it comes back to land, which is another unproven and highly dangerous maneuver not covered in the 2014 FAA EIS. In the FAA's original EIS from 2013 and 14, there were no relandings of craft at this site. The boosters from Falcon 9 launches were to be dumped in the Atlantic or recovered from landing barges, not landing back at this site and creating a second chance for a loss of vehicle with catastrophic effect. These actions and changes of paradigm prove that no matter what conditions you place on Musk and SpaceX after reviewing this new draft programmatic environmental assessment, Musk will continue to do as he pleases until somebody, eventually, is forced to shut the entire complex down. In addition to the May 2014 final EIS, there were also a number of WRs, or written reevaluations. The FAA website summarizes that the contents of the 2014 EIS remain current and substantially valid, despite the fact that the vehicle at the center of those reevaluations is 9 times larger, 1,000 times louder, and twice the height and width of the vehicle at the center of the 2014 assessment, while ignoring the sprawling industrial complex eating up real estate only 2 kilometers away. In short, your written reevaluations on this topic were pure nonsense, and the authors of those papers were in serious denial about the changes being made to the launch vehicle systems and the supporting infrastructure. So now, we are going to dive into a section of the PEA submitted by SpaceX, where Musk outlines the new infrastructure he intends to build to service this grand vision. Starting off with the proposed expansion of the Boca Chica Launch Complex pictured on page 28, expanding it to twice the size it currently is, which is already far larger than what Musk originally proposed for this area. This is cause for great concern as it involves extending and backfilling further and further out into the salt plains and marshlands. Orbital Launch Mount B at the 5 o'clock position of that photo is once again right at the very edge of the facility. At no other facility in Vandenberg or at Cape Canaveral is a launch platform constructed in this fashion. Launch towers at those facilities are located at the center of a well-cleared, normally circular complex, giving a much-needed buffer between launch blast zones and the perimeter of the site. Next up on page 32, Article 2.1.4.7, this describes a proposed 5.4-acre, 250-megawatt, natural gas-powered power station with structures standing 150 feet or 50 meters tall. That is of even greater concern. If such a facility was located at the intersection of Icorn Boulevard and State Highway 4, this would be the massive footprint required for that facility. And that's just for the power plant. Additional infrastructure being introduced in this paper include an expansion of the solar farm to double its size, a natural gas pretreatment facility, a liquefier, and a desalinization plant, all of these quietly listed on page 9. A Twitter personality known as ESG Hound, who is an environmental engineer specializing in compliance, has been gracious enough to share these slides demonstrating our points. Such a facility would require a pipeline to feed 50 million cubic feet of natural gas to it every single day. Constructing that pipeline across these tidal wetlands would be devastating to them. And to obtain 50 million cubic feet of natural gas daily would require the output of 300 newly drilled or fracked wells, and all the associated energy required to drill and operate those wells would be on top of that carbon footprint. Those wells, according to ESG Hound, would be located at least 70 miles away from Boca Chica, because that's where the nearest natural gas producing fields are. This is backed up by the map from the Texas Commission on Environmental Quality. On their map, each red dot is a gas well, and each blue dot is an oil well. This power plant would require the output from 300 more red dots. Additionally, if they are processing the gas on this site, there will be byproducts from that refinement that will need to be disposed of and carted away. Using SpaceX's 250-megawatt station as the starting point, ESG Hound uses their numbers to determine such a facility would require a non-stop array of tanker trucks on State Highway 4 to haul away 1.2 million gallons of wastewater, 6 million gallons of condensate, and 105 million pounds of gas co-product annually from processing the field gas into refined gas that can be used by the power plant. And this in no way, shape, or form addresses the fuel requirements of the launch vehicles. This is just for the power plant that will be running 24/7 every day of the year, as will all the support facilities for that power plant. Moving towards our conclusion. In 2014, the FAA believed they were authorizing a single launch complex for a small rocket system that was endorsed by and created for NASA that would launch monthly resupplies and crew missions for the ISS on weekdays between 7 a.m. and 7 p.m. according to Texas state law. What you have allowed Musk to build in Boca Chica through non-intervention, without county, state, or federal authorization, is his own private community, industrial rocket manufacturing complex, private destructive testing range that pollutes protected sanctuaries, and a multi-pad launch site for a completely different vehicle, more akin to an ICBM, that is unproven, 1,000 times louder, with 10 times the explosive potential of the machine he promised, one that is a threat to everyone and everything in the area, even if it does not explode. To recap some bullet points, Musk told federal and state authorities this site would become a single typical launch platform similar to Cape Canaveral launch pads. Musk lied. This facility has become Musk's own personal destructive rocket testing range and 24/7 industrial manufacturing complex. Musk told federal and state authorities this site would be used to launch variations of Falcon in support of the ISS. Musk lied. Neither the Falcon, Falcon 9, nor Falcon Heavy have ever launched from Boca Chica, nor are there any plans to do so. Musk told federal and state authorities these operations would take place from 7 a.m. to 7 p.m. from Monday to Friday, not on weekends, nor on holidays. Musk lied. He has conducted tests at all hours of the day and night, and the manufacturing facility runs 24/7. Musk told state authorities he would honor an annual cap of 300 hours per year for blocking State Highway 4 to conduct launch operations. Musk lied. The SpaceX security force in the area has in fact closed Highway 4 in excess of 1,000 hours per year, telling those people they are redirecting they have authority from the county for those closures. They also lied, and they are being charged with impersonating law enforcement as a result. Musk constructed a 50-story launch tower without FAA authorization. You told him to stop. He didn't. In fact, he told you in writing this wasn't even a launch tower. Musk lied, and he is daring you now to tell him to remove it. That is the discernible pattern of Elon Musk. He lies. He takes. He forces his way in, and he challenges you to oppose him because if you do, you're against him and his mission to save humanity, which, of course, is all absolute nonsense. You, the FAA, have the authority to stop this in its tracks and make Musk honor his original agreements. Now let's reword that. You have the obligation to stop this in its tracks and make Musk honor his original agreement. You are, in fact, bound by your office's mandate to enforce these laws and shut down Boca Chica operations for non-compliance, to remove all unauthorized structures, and demand this site be returned to its natural state at Musk's expense. You, the FAA, do not get to pick and choose which laws signatory parties have to obey based on their celebrity status. By doing so, you become complicit in the disasters to come, and they will eventually include human fatalities. On the FAA website, it says your enduring mission is to provide the safest, most efficient aviation system in the world. The FAA vision, We strive to reach the next level of safety and efficiency and to demonstrate global leadership in how we safely integrate new users and technologies into our aviation system. We are accountable to the American public and our aviation stakeholders. By ignoring your own declared mantra, you are failing the residents, wildlife, and populated areas around Boca Chica, allowing an eccentric billionaire with a terrible environmental and operational record to continue to operate in defiance of your orders, in breach of your agreements, in violation of state and federal laws, who will try to embarrass you through his 60 million Twitter followers when he doesn't get his way. However, this document is for an environmental assessment. The only conclusion the FAA can reach with regards to its contents is that there is no environmental benefit associated with this proposal, and if it is allowed to proceed, it will irreparably further harm the delicate, unique ecosystems of Boca Chica. Accordingly, as a federal agency entrusted with the public good, the FAA must reject this proposal. We expect you to do your duty. Sincerely, the Common Sense Skeptic and our YouTube community. Our contact information is commonsenseskeptic@gmail.com.